I live for the weekend, and now with the warm weather, I know there are always projects inside and out that I have to get to. So today, we're going to inspire you to tackle some of those outdoor projects with our Reno girls. It's been too long. Please welcome Leanne Allaire-Perot, Danielle Gray, Sarah Gray.
We love working together.
And believe it or not, they did not text each other last night, but they're perfectly coordinated. Like, a little bit of animal, a little bit of denim, a little bit of black. I love it. So you worked very hard on your exteriors, and I could sort of match the exterior with the designer because I know you all so well, but they're all very different. So let's start, Leanne, with your exterior.
Yes.
It's beautiful. You got a punch of color and, of course, that nod to animal print.
Can you tell? You'd never be able to tell which one's mine. I really wanted to show off my personality with this space and to hopefully encourage people to think about their homes as an extension, not only of their inside, but of their personality as well.
Yes.
It's putting your face forward to the street about who lives behind those doors. And speaking of the door, this happens to be my favorite color,
a beautiful
coral. It's my happy hue. And it's funny when I talk to people and I ask them if they have that color in their house, their happy hue, most of the time they say no.
Why not?
Not only put it inside your house, but have it that statement piece on the exterior.
Absolutely.
Now, my facade is actually stucco. And there's a point with this that where I've kept the stucco very neutral. You don't have the option with stucco to have a lot of color and texture and brick or siding. But you also don't want to go too crazy with paint and be that purple house on the street and paint everything flat. So with the stucco, it's a really neutral, nice color, but the key here is accentuating then your architectural features like the window frame and even the door. And I want to point out, I've actually added a back band onto the traditional door frame to beef it up with a header. So to make that focal point of that front door really pop, not only does color work, but beefing out the trim around as well is a really inexpensive weekend project that makes a huge dramatic difference. You can take a stock big box door and make it look like $1 million with the right trim.
The bigger and more grand that door is, it makes such a statement.
Absolutely.
It really does. So what a great way to do it.
And I just want to point out my
rug. DIY.
Because this is a DIY. I picked up the sisal rug from IKEA and just used some leftover exterior paint to paint out my little leopard print.
That's so cute.
Yeah, keep it cheerful.
Good work. Gorgeous greenery. Speaking of greenery, we're going to move down and see this next beautiful exterior done by Danielle. I mean, I love all of the green you're seeing. Let's talk about what you did with your exterior. What did you decide to use?
Well, one of the biggest trends in colors right now for exteriors is black.
Yes.
And this material is actually charred wood. It's charred cedar, and it blackens the wood, so it's a very natural reaction. And you get all of that texture. It's very rich. And we're actually going to show you how to do that here because it's an incredible moisture-resistant, insect-resistant material,
Can you buy it like that? Can you buy lumber like that? Or do you have to do this? This is something that you've got to do yourself.
There are some suppliers that are starting to do this in North America, but you can do it yourself.
Okay.
And we're gonna get out that blowtorch and show you.
Apparently, I'm gonna do it myself later on in the show.
And I'm like the opposite of Leanne in the sense that I kept everything sort of minimalist. So I didn't really make my door kind of disappears in because I wanted the charred cedar to really kind of pop.
Yes.
And I love the way greenery pops against black.
Yeah.
Like it's such an amazing natural kind of combination.
There's a lot of cottages with black now out there.
Exactly.
The lakefront. Mm-hmm.
And for me, this is obviously like an urban setting, right?
Yes.
This is about how wide my house is.
Yes.
And for me, all the sun that I get is on my front porch. So I really take advantage of that for container gardens.
Yes.
And in the summer, veggies and fresh herbs, like I just live for that. And
so,
you know, these are gorgeous pots from Restoration Hardware. And these herbs, rosemary, it just gives it that kind of old world charm.
That's lovely.
I know, doesn't it make you want to cook?
It does.
Do you trust your herbs on your front porch? Like, is this a draw for the creatures? Do they hang out there? Are they waiting for you when you leave for work?
Next door and snipping a little.
Your neighbors. You gotta watch your neighbors.
That's kind of cute, though.
These herbs are okay. They're very fragrant. I don't find that animals are drawn to that. But if you're gonna go that extra sort of level and do some salad greens,
the whole garden
some veggies, you can. This is from Lee Valley. It's called a veggie pod.
Okay.
And this is intense. So it's got this incredible irrigation system. So this is a cover.
Yeah.
It's got a built-in irrigation system. You just hook your hose up to.
Oh.
This protects it from the critters.
Okay.
And from the sun as well, because you want to get lots of sun, but you don't want to burn them in the hot, hot heat. So it's incredible because there's a reservoir in the bottom of this. So this is something, I love that like urban garden thing.
I like that you can have the whole thing, like your whole garden just contained on your front porch.
Exactly.
That's beautiful. Yeah. And then you've got that cover when you need it.
Yeah.
Okay, let's move down a little bit more because we've got this beautiful, light, bright exterior, which I knew was Sharon's.
Yeah, you did a good job.
I know you well. So this is lovely as well in a different way.
In a different way. I mean, I wanted to bring a bit of a West Coast vibe because I love the West Coast, but I don't live there. So I've got my traditional urban brick. But I thought by bringing the lighter colors, sort of a contemporary feel, but also hits of black, because we were talking, all of us use black. We didn't plan it, although we knew about the chard. So we figured. But I think the quickest thing you can do to add a modern feel to the front of your house is by painting out the windows black. So I wanted to show how you can actually do that, but still have a creamy color trim. So I painted out the brick with pashmina, went with a really pretty maritime white, so it's not so black and white.
It's not stark.
So exactly, and I think that what I love about the West Coast is that natural vibe with a lot of the architecture, and there's always black and white, but there's always an element of wood and something that really warms it up.
I love that.
So because I have my tiny little, you know, downtown facade, I didn't put a lot of wood on the exterior, but I thought bringing it into things like furniture. And my dream would be to have a porch that I could sit out. I go to my neighbor's house all the time and sit on theirs, but I would love to have one. So this is a fantastic club chair from ARD Outdoor. And the thing I love about how exterior furniture feels so comfortable, and it feels very interior
now. It does, that looks like a living room chair.
Doesn't it?
I would
absolutely put that in my house. And then it's all about texture too when you have a natural color palette. So hits of black, hits of different texture in the rug. Even if you're covering up a concrete porch, a rug, great thing to do.
Softens it up immediately. Yeah. What's the color of the door?
This is Gloucester Sage. It's one of my favorite greens,
warm.
A lot of gray. Very, very warm. So that's the vibe that I wanted, was something very warm and cozy.
Very nice. And you know you can come and sit on my porch anytime, right?
I have.
And you have. Many, many hours and many, many liters of wine.
Yes.